Howdy folks, and welcome back to Ark Extinction Core on the Crazy Misfits server.
Yeehaw!
It's episode 20. It's time for a server too, don't you think? I think so. Let's start right here. Let's get up. Let's get a little lift off here. Let's get up in the air. Oh, I like that reflection there on the water. That looks nice. Our snowflake, it's coming together quite nicely. I've put up all the diamonds. That one over there looks a little bit different. As you can see, that's our water pen. All the rest, well, it's there. It's painted. I haven't yet worked on the glass ceilings. You see, you can still see the frame and all of that. So that's only done over there to test. Yeah, it looks nice. It's exactly what I wanted. It's perfect. We'll have to see how we can extend from that. If we want to extend from that, what else we can do with this? Probably we're going to use that island over there and extend a little bit. Put up a dino pen for, you know, the big guys over there. Which seem to be all clustered together again because something attacked them. Probably a pig or mustax. Yeah. Anyway, that's our base. What are you doing there? Pokeball, you don't belong here. Well, for now I guess you can just hang out there, although you're kind of blocking my way. Can't get through there anymore. Well, I can do this. Yeah. So, over here, Yeah, I guess I will put walls around, or fences or something to, you know, get rid of the last spawns over here, because this happens all the time. And I'm a little tired of sorting through them. The only one who doesn't care is Sleepy Time over there, Sweet Dreams. Yeah, he just doesn't care. It's good. Alright, let's get going. Alright, first base on our list, right here, pretty much next to us, is Sparry's World, our newest member. This is going to be his final base place. That's a thing now. What? Something loud? Walking around? I can live with that. Put that away. Thank you very much. He's put up some nice walls all around the place using foundations, which is hard to do if you're not using S+. And he's using the castles and keep mod. Omega Monkey! Oh, that's joking. Hanging out here. Very nice. So he's built this big, lovely castle right into the rock over there. We got some surprises here. I think, yeah, right here. See that? That's a secret door. To his resource collection or generation and power and all that stuff. Very nice. So that's one way to hide all the stuff that's too fancy for a castle style build. Got his flags up. Very, very nice. Some decorative items around here, which is gorgeous. It's quite good. S+ item collector over there. Let's have a look around. There's NPCs everywhere. Well, not yet everywhere, but he's getting there. He wants to put NPCs in here to give his castle a little bit of life. There's a fireplace over there and some lovely lock keeping installment, a wood pile, you could call it. Yeah. Some more decorative items. Never ending fire. How much wood did you put in there? Oh, wow. That's definitely a never ending fire. It's good. Some storage and stuff. Under the stairs is where he hides his technical items. Is it joking? Lying around here. Dude, you belong in here. That's not. No. Come in here. That's better. Haha! Alright, let's go upstairs. Nice big staircase. Wonderful. That's where the main crafting area is. Very, very good. Fast leg. Okay. And there you go. Sparry's World. Nice base. You can go up top here. Flyer storage. Little towery extension over there leads him up to that bridge between the two rocks. So there's a lot of room for expansion. I forget that I have this. And a lot of room for more intricate buildings over here. We'll see what happens. This greenhouse over there. Tech originator. Yeah, looks good. Let's move on. Loading, loading, loading. All the bases loading. There's some stuff around here. So hide. Yeah, well. Let's get over here. This is the tiny little island, as you can see there on the top. Behind Volcano and Dead Island. Now, you might think this is a very dangerous place, but technically, there's never anything on this island. Which is quite nice. So what do we have here? A lot of unnamed creatures. That's a good start. And a big pen. Right in the water. Oh, that's nice. I guess this is glass. S plus glass. Mm-hmm. No texture whatsoever. You alright there? Don't lie down. Could be the last time you do. So this seems to be gamer.exe. Dino storage area type place. Well, if you hide all the metal supports for this glass, that's gonna be very confusing. But it's also gonna be pretty cool. Unless you know the exact layout of the build, you would be standing in here having no idea where the next wall is. So this is obviously just a holding area. Maybe to reduce lag. Maybe to take care of all the dinosaurs that are not needed. I mean, I don't see even feeding trough in here. Am I just too blind? No? So unless they have food, they're gonna starve to death over there. Who knows? Definitely interesting. I like the design. It seems to be going out quite a bit further here. I mean, it's an idea for a landing strip, but then again, it's below the water level. You can't really land there. Fires will give you all kinds of trouble. And it's getting dark. Next base. Northern Tropical Island South End. This is where we are. This is the rest of Misu's base. Use these aviary domes as creature storage, which is cool. A lot of snails down there. Well, I mean, this is one way to get your polymer and all that stuff, right? What else? A lot of tamed creatures and people. Lovely little crafting area. Nice and compact. All centered around the forge, which makes sense. Biggest structure you have. Let's stop for a second. Have a look around. Even painted. That's interesting. That still doesn't have a texture. Enough beds. Hello. Hello, Dave. You alright? Yeah, it's a little cramped, but then again, it fits. Jell-O-Matic. Nobody really needs that, but yeah, sure. Central electricity. That seems to be working quite nicely. Oh, that's a thing you can do. That certainly saves space. That is the wrong lamppost, but I guess he figured that himself. A little green. Lakitu! This is where Lakitu hangs out. Maybe that's a combined base or something like that? You never know. Come on, let me get up. Is a skeletal stego, just disregard that. There's a wyvern in here. Alpha Quetz. With a bone skin. It's nice. Alright. Let's move on. And then obviously on the South Tropical Island we have Joe King's base. We've been here before. Used the artifact teleporter hub over there to get around and placing our own teleporters for our main artifact hub for the community. So let's see, we have a lovely greenhouse in here. Since when are you doing this? Automatic sword on. Vacuum bubble, it might be the vacuum bubble. Like, if you throw something here, it gets picked up. Other thing? Anything to throw? No, I need all of that. Alright, I will test that at home, I guess. Some of these things are pretty damaged. Well, then again, if you have open walls, stuff can get in here. Tech originator, very nice. No tech replicator. All the other main crafting stations. Yeah, it's a very compact setup. Two kibble tables. Oh, well, if things don't get fast enough, then I guess that's what you do. Gravestone. Oh, wow. We need repair. A lot. I don't really see the industrial grill being that useful when we have this lovely campfire mod thing that I'm using. But sure, why not? All the crop plots are there. That's nice, since you don't really need to access them if you have the resource pull gun. Why not put them up there? And, well, if you have flight, if you need to come up here, I guess it's not a big deal. Yeah, sure. Utilize what you have. Very nice, except for all the damage, which would drive me mad, personally. Especially if you have flight and you can repair it. And I guess this is going to be upgraded. How did you manage to damage those? Oh, wow. Do you have a problem with alphas? As a Pteranodon, we rescued a while ago, and a lot of teleporters for getting around the island. That's nice. We even have one for the community app over here, I believe. Yeah, I put that there. Because I was coming here so often, I needed to have a quick way of getting here. Alright, that's Joe Kingspace. Let's move on to the Redwoods. A wild mortuary appears. There you go. We're here at the loveliest location in the Redwoods, where the waterfall is, right on top of the Redwoods, where you have the most beautiful sight over all of the center, and you have that big cave over there, which I think he isn't actually using. Park my Pteranodon down there. Alright, let's have a look. Yeah, no, he's not using this. Maybe for the metal and the crystal and the stones. But certainly not for a building currently. He's built his little crafting setup down here. There's not much to it. It's really just a starter setup with the main crafting station so you can get to building your base before you set everything up on your actual platform, like over here. Oh, wow. That's a thing. It's not a turkey. All right. So he's building this lovely little mostly circular platform out of triangle ceilings and regular glass ceilings, and this must be a pain in the butt. I'm so happy that they do have a frame when you place them and you can see what is what. This would drive me nuts. But then again, once you've done placing all the things and you don't have to repair anything, you don't have to fill any holes, everything is working out. Yeah, sure. Why not do it completely transparent so you have this lovely view down? That's amazing. You can build so many great things with this. I mean, this can be easily a multi-tiered platform build, like have the next platform attached over here, going down a little bit so you can see where the water stream is coming from, and then maybe all the way down so you have one of the actual platforms, the real platforms attached to one of the trees here. And so you can build a spiral staircase thing or whatever. There's so much room for things. Well, not upwards. We reach the ceiling here pretty soon. But other than that, yeah, I'm looking forward to see what's going to happen here. Mortuary hasn't been on in a while. Doing more Conan builds, which is a grind in itself. So I'm eager to see what happens when he comes back here with fresh ideas. It's already looking great. Alright, let's move on. And we're at Bowden's base, right here in the middle of the Redwoods. Right over here. So, since we've been here the last time, I mean, we've been here quite often, that down there is our main teleporter to the Redwoods. Because this is normally a pretty safe area, because, you know, buildings prevent spawns in this area, so except for anything wandering in from over there, or there, which is a relatively narrow area where you can wander in. I mean, you run against that rock and turn around, or you run through this narrow passage here. A little bit wider over there, but then again there's lots of room for creatures, so why would they wander over here when they already have lots of room? That was my main reason for putting a teleporter here, to just be a little bit protected if anything happens, just, you know, run inside. Lovely water pen, nothing in here. I'm pretty sure there was something in here at some stage and then it got killed. Being on passive and all that happens once in a while. That's a little bit crooked. I'm not going to talk about Crooked. No. Not going to get into another war with Bowden here over my affinity of having everything straight. You know. Alright. That's the main base over here. Pretty nice. So what he's done basically is he's used this overhang as the border for his build and then placed the dino gates accordingly a little bit to the inside. So if anything falls down, it will fall outside the gates. Not into his base, makes it very, very secure. He had a second floor up there a while ago, which he needed to tear down because of dinosaurs disappearing. Maps have these weird thing with dead spots. When you use Structures Plus, you don't notice that because no collision detection, all of that, so you can just build. What you do afterwards is you craft yourself a simple campfire. And then you put that in your hotbar and press the key accordingly so you get the green outline. And then you basically walk through your base with this campfire ready to place and try to find a spot where it turns red and says cannot place. And then it's for you to figure out if that's a space where it cannot place because you're placing it on an incline or something where it won't place. Or, you know, top down. Or if it's actually just, you know, a horizontal floor and it should place and it just won't, if that's the case, then you found a dead spot. That's where you don't want to be. Because if you park a dinosaur in that dead spot, and you go out of rendering distance, come back, it's gone. It's just how it works. So he tore the whole thing down just to be on the safe side. I mean, reaching dead spots is probably somewhere up there. So there is still room for two or three more stories on top of this if Bowden really wants to. What do we have here? Towers. That's nice. I still have to figure out how to color these. Because when I place them down and I come with a paintbrush, nothing will happen. So maybe you can only do this when you have a spray can and you know which area that is. Or you have to do it in your inventory when you have dyes. I don't know. I haven't figured that out yet. And there's things for me that I have to figure out. Believe it or not. Inside! So this is his main production street. Everything's set up. Everything has power. Yeah, all the crafting stations. A little addendum here. Tech originator running. Do you need to be running, wasting stuff? Don't think so, huh? Plus element. Really does. The crafting station still has some element. That's nice. Could leave some here if we were nice neighbors. We're not. It's easy to get. Come on. Anybody really needs some? I can farm some in 5 minutes. No problem. Yeah, everything here looks good. Meat. Thank you very much. I'm stealing your meat. Actually, quite a good idea. Right, let's check upstairs. There is an upstairs, which is actually enclosed. We do have a second floor. There's some crop plots over here. Very nice. Bare minimum things. Mushrooms and chitin. Not enough cementing paste. I know that feeling. That's a dodo with a chieftain hat. No, it's a turkey. I know. Hello. Rat skeleton. Alright. Guess you could call him that. Lot of dinosaurs, some of which I recognize. Hello. Yeah, little space out there. All right. Where? Did I park? Off to the next base. Ouch. Incoming community center. I'm down. By Kason. Yeah, found that up there at the ceiling, so thought might be a good idea to bring it back down. Wah! There you go. Don't be sad. We're back home now. Everything's good. Punch in the face. So, community center. Nothing changed over here. More creatures. Wow. Hey, Wesley. Beautiful. I like Spinos. We do have a little bit of a teleporter problem here. We're getting more and more, which is quite nice. I'm not complaining. I think I put that one down. Somebody else put the sign down. Very nice. Space World, yeah. Mortuary, we've seen that. The Traveling Viking, we haven't been there yet. Might as well. Rad's Ridge. Kason, yeah, we definitely need to go to Kason, and that's the one for our artifact hub. Somebody put up a sign, look at that. Who's living here? A key too. Alright, let's quickly go to Kason. Why not? Saves a little bit of time. And we're under the world. Or down a hill. Down a hill it is. Very open dinosaur storage, so that's very economy friendly and good on egg laying and well, you know what I mean. Right, what do we have over here? Metal clots. A square metal thing. This looks like a bungalow type of deal. Over the water. Storing his creatures in the water, which is actually a good thing. They will keep the pond clean of anything that can hurt you, and you can just go in there and get all the pearls in the world. That's good. Pretty sure you can get a Mossa in here. Barely, but I'm pretty sure you could. So, the underside is wood. Now, this is probably all structures plus, right? Yeah. So, if that's all structures plus, then there is no issue. Otherwise, this wood can get destroyed fairly easily, and that would obviously break foundation support for everything hanging above it. So not really the best idea to have metal on top and wood at the bottom, but I guess it's not that done yet, or he just doesn't care because it's S plus. Hello, red one. Let's go in here. Pretty bare minimum. Generator. You do know we have solar panels, right, Kason? Right. Let's go or not. On top. Let's fly on top. More dinosaur storage. Alright, so there's not much in here. I know this was a wood base before with pretty much everything set up. So I guess he's just in the process of transforming everything into metal. This is actually a wall. Alright, not a door frame. Stupid me. And that's pretty much done. Maybe a little bit of color. Maybe a little bit more working on transparency and shape of windows and walls and things. Looks interesting. Yeah. Let's see what that will turn out to be. There's the teleporter. Once he puts his back into it and does the rest. And last but not least, the traveling Viking. No. Have I been here before? Hello, where are we? Oh, I know where we are. Anunnaki Season 2, I believe, is when we build over here and had our lovely little landing platform out here and all our crafting set up in there with our own water pen through there. And then the whole world went corrupt and nothing would work. And everything went south. Home base. Oh, I think this is home base. I don't know, maybe that's just his on-the-fly teleporter to get back when he needs to. Alright, what do we have here? Glass metal smithy, and a forge, and more teleporters, metal spot 2, very nice, having alternatives, A. Well, A sounds to me like the teleporter if you want to get home quickly and you just have to type one letter. So maybe that right there is another base location? Maybe over there? Have a look! What's going on here? Something's going on. Seems to me like somebody's getting ready to do something over there. It looks interesting. Sure, why not? Anything over there? Anything up there? There's too many trees up there for anything to be there. Alright. Future's down here. Yeah. Gates to block off the area. That should work for a while. Lovely bluish wyvern. Near. Ooh, another wyvern. Another gate. Blocking all this area off. That's perfect. Yep, that's gonna be a big base. That's pretty much what we covered in Anunnaki Season 2. This whole freaking area. And it was fun. We had our greenhouse in here for resource crops. Up there. And all the main crafting over there, dino storage over there, and the big creatures down here, and then we did the big warden fight, and then everything went south, and nothing worked, and we were pretty screwed. Alright, let's try to find my way back home. Wasn't it that one? I don't know. Well, just teleported, fell through the world by some kind of weird glitch, and lost all my stuff, and the gravestone wouldn't give it back, so I guess that's gone. Oh well. That's how it works sometimes. So let me know in the comments below if you liked the video, if you liked the little base tour. If you want to see more about those bases, check out the different guys. Their channels should be in the description below. If not, let me know when I add them. And that's it for today, folks. If you liked the video, subscribe for more, leave a comment if you feel like it. Don't forget to enjoy yourselves. See you soon.